Welcome into the Going Fun Esports Championships here for the finals in the losers bracket between Integrity and between Haze. I don't know why I just had a little bit momentary lapse of remembering who we were seeing play, but we're about to get into game number two between them to find out if Haze is going to be able to make it back into the grand finals to face off once again against their rivals of EVH, or if Integrity are going to be able to fire right back as we get into the pick and bans. We have Fizz and Thresh being taken off the table.
Exactly, and you know, Haze right here looks strong in game number one, as they pretty much always do, unless they hit their kryptonite in EVH. Of course, took a 30-minute win roughly over Integrity just moments ago right here. So definitely going to be looking forward to see if Integrity can battle on back here, and you know, maybe it's going to be by focusing down bubbles in the mid lane.
Yeah, as they're doing, they got the Fizz, they got the Syndra going right to that bench with the poor fish, and Thresh going to be aimed at Aeon. He is definitely a very great player on that champion, loves to get those hooks. And the second man going to be that Ivern.
Yeah, definitely have seen the Ivern pulled off to great success here in the last couple of days here at the Going Fun Esports Championship. But of course, you know, it really does enable your carries to get a lot of work done here there in the back lines, and that is something that these teams do need to look out for. We haven't seen too many carry top laners from either of these players. It's been a lot more about the tankier styles, allowing their mid laners and their AD carries to get a lot more work done in the later stages of the game.
Yeah, especially the Poppy, definitely something very popular here in Malta. We've talked about it a lot. But we actually get to see a Kalista ban aimed right at Asmalex, who does like to use that to really get great objective control on that champion, while Lulu is going to be just more of a staple meta ban in the current time.
Yeah, red side, you gotta ban the Lulu pretty much, otherwise that's gonna be locked in almost immediately here. And right now there's a lot of strong champions open. We haven't seen any real power bans here, minus the Lulu. I'd say it'd be the only one you'd sort of qualify as that. So there's not a whole lot of priority, I don't think, here on whatever the first pick might be from Integrity. Of course, they won't have the option to have a counter pick for either their mid lane or their AD carry.
No, but they're going to have that first pick, Ashe, coming in. Still leaves a lot on the table without really showing too much of your hand. It doesn't show that you're trying to go for one sort of playstyle or another, but it does allow them for a really good pick comp.
Yeah, roughly probably one of the best AD carries on the patch, absolutely. It's, you know, got a strong laning phase, you can shove in the waves very early on, and of course that arrow, just massive pick potential all across the board, going to be able to really get the ball rolling in that mid game, searching for arrows, trying to get picks off of it. And you don't have to, you know, focus in on a full-on pick composition. Maybe you can take something more, a little more carry oriented out of the jungle, like a Graves perhaps, something that's not going to bring a whole lot of crowd control to the table, and the Ashe pick will sort of make up for that lack.
Yeah, and Graves is definitely a strong champion in the jungle in the current iteration of the game. Someone you have to look out for, despite the little nerfs that he received not too long ago. It was something that was so inconsequential to what he actually likes to do. But now we get to see that Haze, they're going to be picking up the Nami, and they're going to be picking up that Ahri.
Right, and the Nami might seem like sort of an oddball right here, but when you look at the other supports left up, it's probably the Karma is the one that jumps out at you immediately as being something very strong right now, but Nami does have a favorable matchup into that champion. A lot of pros really do like taking that when they see a Karma locked in, so maybe by Worku calling for the Nami right here, that puts a little less priority on the side of Integrity to lock that in for themselves, even though it's not a hard counter by any means, and of course the Karma would just be an all-around fantastic pick as well here for the side of Integrity if they wanted to make sure that they secure themselves priority down in the bottom lane.
Yeah, but you almost have to wonder if that allows for the side of Integrity to go for something a little bit more aggressive, like the Malzahar, like the Zyra, since Karma has a favorable matchup into both of those champions. Well, Nami, not necessarily as much, as we get to see the Gragas going to be picked up by the side of Integrity with that Ziggs in the mid lane.
Well, we saw Shadow pull out his Ziggs earlier in the week when they were facing off against the Raving Raptors, pulling the Donut Dominator special on him, and we mentioned Donut Dominator was looking a little bit weaker. Shadow really came into his own here or there rather, on the Ziggs pickup out of the mid lane. It's a very dangerous choice when you already know that you're facing off against the Ahri, someone who can close the gap on you, and Ziggs, we all know, likes to keep his distance from the people he's playing on against right here. So Shadow will have a pretty large challenge to face off against here in the mid lane, although I'm definitely excited to see how he pulls off this Ziggs pickup once more.
I think it'll be really reliant on Van Cleef and where he decides to make his pressure known on that Gragas, if that is for him, or if he does flex that into the top lane. We still gotta see exactly where that's gonna go. It's gonna be really dependent on what Haze pick up for themselves as they go for that Poppy, one of their staple top laners, and then the Lucian for Asmalex.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the Gragas is gonna go into the jungle right here. Not because it has a horrible matchup versus the Poppy by any means, but more because Van Cleef really does like playing the Gragas for himself. We haven't seen too much of that coming out of Zanzwa. So of course, looks like it might just be a much more heavy focus on the team fight composition from Integrity, whereas on the other hand, you've got Haze, who appear to be a little bit more skirmish-oriented. You know, the Ahri, the Lucian want to be sort of jumping in their opponents' faces right here, and if they're fighting in closed-off corridors, that's not going to be too good of a look for them against all the crowd control and all the AoE damage that Integrity have already chosen for themselves.
Yeah, they're even locked themselves in that Nautilus. He's going to be having a really advantageous time in those close quarters, like you mentioned, going to be able to get a nice depth charge onto someone in the back line, knock everyone up if they're all crowded together, and then the Bard picked up to really help them out if they think the going gets a little too tough.
Yeah, very interesting right there. Of course, can be excellent setup for Mega Inferno Bomb, for Zod, to get a good arrow at the same time. So there's definitely a lot of long-range engage potential on the side here of Integrity. They want to be able to start fights off with a click of one or two buttons, and I think that's very good for them because, again, if they're getting these, you know, full-blown team fights, their composition is going to thrive against the likes of Haze, and it'll be much more up to this Poppy Pancake Puff rather to try and knock away some of the frontliners, and that's maybe how Haze could win a potential team fight. Wow.
Yeah, I know why you're saying wow, because I'm saying wow right along with you. It's going to be a flex Poppy into the jungle with an Akali top lane, a Pancake Puff special coming here for the Going Fun Esports Championship, something we really don't get to see too often.
I mean, Pancake Puff has played it before to incredible effect. I remember one or two games with him on that champion in the group stages. It looked really good for himself, but this is an interesting time to pull it out right here. Of course, Haze are already up one game, so they can afford to lose one, potentially go for something a little bit riskier, and that's maybe why we're seeing this sort of flex here, throwing the Akali into the top lane. But Poppy's another interesting one too, because we've seen this champion flexed down to the support role, apart from it just being in the top lane, and now pulling the full-on switcheroo here on Integrity.
Yeah, and I just want to ask you before we throw it over to our sponsors, just so we can talk a little bit about the Poppy and what you expect of it coming into this matchup.
Yeah, well, I think that Poppy, specifically against the Gragas, is quite effective. Obviously, you have a Steadfast Presence to try and cancel out his Body Slam, which is his primary playmaking tool in the early game. And apart from that, it's really going to have a similar role to the top lane Poppy. You're going to build tanky, and within team fights, it's going to be very important to try and knock away the beefy frontliners, the Gragas and the Nautilus, so that your double assassins can try to access Shadow and Zod in the back lines.
Well, there you have it. Hopefully we can see that Ruby pulls off something really special with this Poppy pickup in the jungle and that Akali in the top lane for Pancake Puff, but we're going to throw it over to our sponsor, so guys, we'll be right back. We'll be right back.
officers. What's going on? We're in the middle of an epic car chase. Is that why you're moving in slow motion?
Epic car chases are always done in slow motion.
That's a bit cliche. Going for a donut.
Donut.
Smart. The moment the juice gently drips down your patty, when your taste buds meet real wholesome meat, that's when you know you're in a point of no return. You realize you're lost in the pleasures only a true meal can offer. You're lost, but you sure as hell don't want to be found. Hugo's Burger Bar. Let's burger like never before.
Life's about looking for little moments of happiness. Moments when we come out of the cold and into the welcoming warmth. Delicious leisurely mornings or long lazy afternoons, where we dream sweet dreams and take the time to finally be ourselves. When you find these little moments of happiness, life becomes irresistible, a journey to be enjoyed. And Costa is there with you, every sip of the way.
I am you.
Back for game number two between Haze and Integrity to find out who's gonna be able to make it past the loser's bracket back into the grand finals, or if we're gonna see Integrity be able to really fire back here with their Shadow on Ziggs and with Pancake Puff on Akali to find out exactly how these things will play out.
Yeah, it's gonna be a very fun one to watch unfold right here. I think you're all impressed with Shadow Ziggs earlier on in the week, and of course Haze, they might have been impressed by it too, because they drafted three backline divers if you count the Poppy too, just try and lock down both Shadow and Zod, and the game is really gonna lie on those two shoulders because there's no other damage threats really coming out of their team. It's a little bit different from Haze, who have a more carry oriented top laner in that Akali for Integrity. It's going to be about getting their frontliners beefy and strong so that they can try and protect Shadow and Zod.
Yeah, but one thing I definitely want to bring up is going to be Pancake Puff on the Akali. We don't really get to see Akalis at all in competitive play. It's just not something that's been really touched since she got the minor reworks back at the Assassin rework, like the Assassin update, or even before that. But Pancake Puff still feels confident going into this matchup against the Nautilus.
It's definitely an interesting one, and you know, if we expect anything out of this pick, it's to rush a very early Hextech Gunblade. That's fairly standard on the champion. You know, the hybrid values you get from your passive can be very, very valuable to the champion, as well as just any sustain when you are playing a carry into a tank. Think Fiora, how you know her matchups really start to favor when she gets some lifesteal under her belt, and well, that's a nice stun.
That was the bait coming in from Aeon and Zod. They just wanted to see if they could get a lot of poke onto Azmolex, and they did a fantastic job of that.
Yeah, definitely a good one right there. Went a little bit differently in the mid lane. Bubbles got the very good level 1 trades, landing a lot of those orbs to be quite effective. Oh no!
Oh, but look at the stuns consistently landing onto Azmolex. They even used the exhaust, got the flash and heal out of the Lucian to make sure that they could just get as much pressure in the bot lane as possible. Ruby is going to have to start picking up that slack with that Poppy.
Yeah, I mean, a little bit unfortunate that Aeon actually wound up taking exhaust in this game. Otherwise, that very well could have been the first blood, just using the early power of the Bard Ashe to, you know, sort of dominate this low range AD carry in the Lucian pick. But of course, Aeon wanted to take the exhaust because he knows there's gonna be an Ahri and an Akali jumping on towards them in the later stages of the game, and that trade-off may have just cost them a little bit right there.
Yeah, really, really well done by Aeon, as just going for the Cosmic Bindings consistently, just landing them onto Azmolex and onto Worku. But Worku being on the Nami, going to be able to sustain the lane pretty efficiently. One pop popped by Azmolex, but it doesn't really matter because Nami, as long as she has mana, she'll be able to keep you healthy.
Yeah, the issue is going to come 2 minutes, 3 minutes down the road if this trading continues, honestly. You know, where Azmolex just continually getting chunked out, and it looks like it could go that way.
Yeah, he's going to get it. The Ignite onto Zod, trying to see if they can get anything, and Ruby in the mid lane did go for the Heroic Charge on Shadow, dodging away from the Charm, using the Barrier, keeping himself safe. Here comes Van Cleef, going to get the Flash Bubble. Ooh. They're going to get everything. First Blood, go for the Van Cleef. Ruby going to be in a lot of trouble, having to run away from the Gragas. Red Buff slow, taking him away, taking him so low. One more hit would have done it, but he didn't want to go for the dive.
Yeah, a little bit surprised there. It looked like Van Cleef had a barrel available and just never pulled it out right there. Ruby did still have Flash available, so if the going got a little bit rougher right there. Should have been able to flash out in enough time to juke away from that ability, but a very nicely played counter gank by Van Cleef.
And that flash body slam, oh, we gotta respect that coming in from Agragas. He was able to land it onto both members of Haze and get them that first kill. And now the waves and the lanes are going just so efficiently for the side of Integrity that they're winning this early game in a surprising fashion.
Yeah, being able to shut down that Ahri just a little bit. And that dive probably would have gone horrendously wrong right there for Integrity. Van Cleef, no flash. Keep in mind, so it's going to be very difficult to actually try to pull something out right here. Feels like he's just wasting a little bit more time and may have been better spent getting a deep ward in that side of the jungle that he was just occupying right there to make sure at least that his dual lane could play safe there, because right now they don't necessarily know where Ruby is on the map, and that Poppy could definitely try to path down bottom lane and punish this duo.
The Poppy's something we've got to keep an eye on. We talked about it a little bit in Champ Select. Just wanted to get a little brief talking points. But now that we get to see it, the impact it's having, going for the Chilling Smite as well, it's going to be, I think, a little bit awkward for the Poppy when it goes for the ganks.
I mean, I'm not personally a huge fan of Chilling Smite on any junglers outside of perhaps Rek'Sai. Just to make sure you can get the knockup, but personally, I have played some Poppy jungle. I believe that, you know, a warding trinket, or warding smite rather, the tracker's knife is probably going to be the best one all around for her, just especially in a competitive sense. But if you are trying to go for a lot of ganks, there's definitely some value in that.
Yeah, she's wrapping around the bubble, not going to connect on the Zod, but they're going to just go right on the Zod. He's going to flash away. Aeon going to be the next target, has the flash heal coming in from Zod to keep him alive. The exhaust had just come up for Aeon to get rid of as much damage.
Yeah, and that's the benefits of Zod and Aeon not using their summoner spells when they went for that aggressive trading style down there in the bottom lane. So they still had those available. And the fact that they didn't try to flash forward aggressively, try to get a last hit onto Osmolex when he was taken down very low, actually ended up saving their lives right there with that gank down in the bottom lane. Although they will be quite vulnerable for the next few minutes.
As we have the flash coming in from Bubbles, but now Ruby gonna be going in onto Shadow. The damage there, got the return kill. The satchel charge almost made him go into tower range. The smite's gonna be able to secure the kill for Ruby.
Well,
so despite the gank, was a one-for-one trade.
That's why you take blue spite magic, just for the execute damage. That's all you need.
That's what it's for.
Right there. Yeah, and not sure if... Yeah, I believe barrier was up for Shadow right there, so a little bit unfortunate they wasn't able to use it right there. Still, though, trading a kill onto the Ahri in a matchup that should be disadvantageous for Shadow as this Ziggs player. That's going to be a very good sign for him moving on forward here when you keep in mind that he does have about a 12 CS lead right now.
That's the most surprising thing, that he's just been doing a fantastic job in that CS department. With the kill being on high on Bubbles earlier from the side of Van Cleef, it really did allow Shadow to just get full control of that mid lane.
I mean, every single lane is going the way you'd expect it. Mid lane, bottom lane. Well, after the couple of kills in the mid lane, but of course bottom lane 2 has the advantage. Top lane, going to be in favor of Pancake Puff. That's not too far out of the imagination at the moment, but I mean, it's going well for Integrity. They needed their carries to get ahead. Shadow's got, you know, a kill and assist in the mid lane. You get down bottom lane, Zod has just been consistently shoving this lane and getting that CS advantage for himself. So at least for right now, they're going to be very happy with how this early game has sort of panned out.
Biggest thing going to be if they can make sure to translate this to the mid game. If they can make team fights go their way, as they have really good opportunities for fights compared to the side of Haze.
Yeah, they definitely have the teamfight composition. That was sort of the big point we were trying to make in Champ Select, is the fact that they can start fights from a mile away. All it takes is an arrow or Bard ultimate, and then everything else will just sort of, you know, fit right into place for them Haze, though, on the other hand, they're going to be looking much more to try and snowball a little bit. It's a lot more difficult with this Poppy out of the jungle. She doesn't have the best time ganking because, you know, actually getting an enemy to walk near a wall so you can get that stun is very difficult. That's why, you know, even when she ganked down bottom lane, she has to do that big loop around where she comes through the tri-brush to actually make anything work out. Otherwise, of course, she's not going to be knocking you in the right direction. Even though she did get her sort of Poppy's quote-unquote perfect gank off, the fact that you don't have any walls that you can send someone into is really the reason why she wasn't ultimately able to lock down either Zod or Ayon for the kill.
And now we actually get to see the warding coming in from the side of Integrity. They're making sure that Ruby can't do that again. They're waiting so that the summoners can come back up for Zod and for Ayon so that if Poppy does go for that long loop run, they're going to be able to spot her out a mile away.
I mean, not even a long loop. There's just no way for her to get into that river right here. And that's going to be very, very good for them because they know this Ashe Bard are going to be shoving down there in the bottom lane. And maybe that allows Van Cleef to get something done on the top half of the map. Just leave Zod and Aeon to their own devices because right now it's already sort of going well for them.
And Bubbles was looking for the roam potential on the Ahri, but the warding just being really strong for Integrity. You gotta give them a lot of props for how they're handling this early game after having lost game one and a little bit more of a decisive stomp. They're just going to try to see if they can win lane, win game.
Yeah, tides might be turning down here very shortly though because Ruby figured out the way to bypass the wards. It's down through the lane.
Yeah, they're gonna go right through, get the kill on to Worku from Zod. They didn't even need Ruby. They had the damage once they hit level 6. Now the mid lane gonna be a little sketchy foreshadow. The Spirit Rush is there, gonna connect. One more hit, the Ignite was burning. Bubbles able to pick up the kill.
Well, that's Haze just turning up the heat right there. Nothing else to say about that. Zod not having time to pop the heal, still no flash available, and that's a very nicely timed gank by Ruby. Even though he didn't actually get a kill or assist right there, the fact that he had the plan to return to this lane before the flash was back available for Zod is very, very good here for Haze, and at the same time, Bubbles getting a solo kill in the mid lane just makes all the momentum go into their hands.
That's, I think, even more impactful than the gank just being successful is the fact that both of the lanes, the bot and mid, that were losing so heavily, were able to get kills without actually needing Ruby. They were behind, yet somehow still able to turn the switch on, get everything going in their favor, and get the momentum back.
Yeah, and something that might be a little bit scary right here. Pancake Puff is sitting on 2,600 gold at the moment.
Wow.
He's still sitting in this lane. That's highly disrespectful. I believe he also went for a little bit of a dirty farming between the turrets right there. Has a good deep ward, so he'll know if Van Cleef is approaching. And at the same time, Zanzo doesn't even want to mess with this Akali. He has a recall under his belt, has a Sunfire cape, but is still down 30 or so CS at the moment. And this Akali might just pick up all her components of a Gunblade pretty soon.
Yeah, here comes the back. I want to see what she gets. Oh. Actually going for tank. She got herself a Spirit Visage and a Longsword.
Yeah, well, it's gonna be into the Gunblade next, I'd imagine. But hey, that's a perfect recall if you want to just complete a major item on the first base. Ruby's mid.
Ruby is mid. Not gonna connect anything just yet. Satchel Charge able to get Shadow out of there. Ooh. Trying to see if he can flash away Mega Inferno Bomb. Only gonna connect on the Ruby. They had the damage. That's gonna be another kill for High on Bubbles on the Shadow.
Yep, there you go. Nicely done now, bottom lane.
The bot lane, the calling coming in, getting the kill. The Tempered Fate was not in time to save the life of Zod. Aeon does get himself out with a nice Cosmic Binding, but sadly not able to save the Ashe.
I mean, the second time in a row where Zod doesn't use summoners. He had heal both this time, last time never popped it, and this time too had the flash as well. You can flash away from the culling, and he did not elect to do so right there from what looked like a fantastic start by the side of Haze. All of a sudden, your mid lane carry, 1-3. Your ADC, 0-2 at the moment, and that is a very, very disturbing turn of events right there.
With the first tower being picked up, they get that over to Azmalect and Worku. Gonna allow the Lucian and Nami, who were struggling, to get a significant gold lead, about 1,300 over their opponents. Gonna now try to translate that into a dragon.
Yeah, this is not a Drake you want to contest if you are Integrity. Pancake Puff, yes, TP, doesn't even matter. He's going to roam on down here anyway. Make sure that there's nothing Integrity can do. And by the time Zanza shoves up that top lane, Pancake Puff can easily just rotate on back there.
That's exactly what they're going to do. You see Pancake Puff already pathing back to the top lane. And one thing I want to mention, because we're talking about builds, we pretty much see standard things coming in from almost every single person that we'd really expect. Bomby Cinder going to be picked up by Ruby, going to go for that Runic Echoes for Van Cleef and then go tanky. But Pancake Puff is seemingly going this route that almost makes me think maybe, just maybe, we might see more of like a Bruiser sort of Akali build.
I don't even know if he needs to go Bruiser after this, honestly, because if you look at what you're against four magic dealers. If you're going to be ganked, it's by Gragas and Nautilus, both of which are going to be dealing magic damage. So building this early Spirit Massage makes you sort of a monster, honestly. You're too tanky to actually take down from anyone on Integrity. The actual damage dealers are weak as well. So Pancake Puff, even though he could go more Bruiser after this, I don't think he necessarily needs to now that he has this MR item, at least for the next two or maybe even three items.
Will be interesting to see exactly the pathing Pancake Puff does take if he goes for the Bruiser, or if he goes, like you said, more for what he needs, what is going to be more impactful, because you're right, it's not really helpful to be that Bruiser when you already have pretty much the frontline tank coming in from Ruby, but the arrow not connecting for Zod means no possible kill on to Azmalex.
Yeah, a little bit unfortunate too, because Van Cleef is just sitting in the brush up there. They wanted to try and force a play, and that's going to be relatively difficult to pull off right now unless Azmalex jumps in.
Yeah, that's going to be the flash body slam. Tidal Wave going to just separate them. Tempered Fate not hitting, but that is going to be an explosive cast, letting them get the kill onto Azmalex.
Yeah, very interesting right there. Van Cleef held on to the cask for a long time. It's an incredibly risky thing to do right there, but it ends up paying off for the side of Integrity and could blow up in just a second now, because Ruby is your classic mid laner. He just walks on in here. He's covering for Bubbles, who, of course, is rotated back up into the top lane to make up for Azmalex going down.
And now we have just essentially the classic Australia lanes. Switching lanes up for both the bot laners and top laners since the towers are down means that Pancake Puff has a little bit easier time just pushing up as far as humanly possible on that Akali, while Zenzawa is forced to just stay as a bodyguard. He's more of a goalie than anything else in this game.
I mean, 5 minutes ago, the bottom river was just, you know, sprinkled in so many Integrity wards. Now it really has gone under the control of Haze at the moment, and when Van Cleef shows on the top side, that allows this Akali to go very aggressive. I mean, right now, Pancake Puff is stealing away a red buff just to continue his domination down here in the bottom lane, and the rest of his team is so enabled to just play completely top-centric, knowing that he can virtually 1v2 at the moment.
And no dragons either really makes it so that they don't have to worry about it. Zod getting hit up by a bubble. That's actually pretty big. The Ignite was dropped on to the Ash. He was able to stay alive. Teleport coming in. Zenzawa wants to start off the fight. They land the arrow onto Azmalex. He's taking really low. The buff did cancel with Azmalex just taking so much damage. He's able to get out of there. Flash coming in. Cosmic Binding does lock up the Lucian. Cast going to be blowing up, trying to see if they can get the kill on the Poppy. He's taking very low. That's going to be two kills for the side of Integrity, but they did lose Shadow in the mid lane.
Yeah, it's pretty massive right there for them. Shadow, I believe, was caught looking at the top lane right there, throwing out the Mega Inferno Bomb, and Pancake Puff electing not to finish the TP right there, I think ends up, honestly, being Haze's demise. They thought they were going to have that fourth member joining them. Pancake Puff definitely strong at the moment, and at best, he's going to be able to trade that turd in the bottom lane, but Bubbles 2 getting good work done in the mid lane.
And I think that's what's more important for them right now. They just are like, let's get the objectives. Let's get the towers. The tower actually is going to fall for the bot lane. They got the Pancake Puff was able to pick that one up. And that was the call they went for. It was a risky call. They lost two in the top lane, lost the tower. But they were able to trade a tower and actually a kill in the mid lane because Bubbles was able to style on Shadow.
Exactly. And that turret mid very, very low. Top lane as well in favor of Haze. That turret was taken down below 50% HP, so in the future, Haze is going to have a much easier time of knocking down those standing turrets, especially if they can sort of contain the Ziggs from just mindlessly clearing the waves.
And the Ziggs pickup, he's gone for a different build than we've seen him go in the past. He's gone for a little bit more of that defensive with that Negatron cloak, not wanting to get bursted down so far from bubbles as he has already in this game. 1-4-2 on the Ziggs pickup, but being able to get that mid lane tower, get some of that standing gold to be a little bit more equalized, definitely going to help out his team.
Yeah, was traded in the top lane, of course. Ozmlex went straight up there after the skirmishing, so still a 3-2 turret advantage in favor of Hayes at the moment. That's a fairly nice pickup, too, for them, because there is another Ocean Drake coming up in just over 30 seconds right now. So they put Ozmlex up there, takes the turret. Now they can just rotate on back down towards this neutral objective.
It's only 17 minutes into the game. Neutral objectives still only being a Rift Herald and a Dragon. Ocean Drake going to be the key target for the side of Haze, but Integrity, do you really want to fight against Haze for that Dragon?
It's definitely going to be a hard fight to pull off if they do decide to go for it. Team fighting is where they are strongest, but right now, gold down about 1,700, not going to be too bad, but if you get caught...
Yeah, you catch out Nautilus, the tank, before they're able to do anything. That's going to be the Tempered Paint onto three-member Omega Inferno Bomb, doing a lot of damage. They have the kill onto Ozmlex, the killing spree for Van Cleef, but they got the kill onto Aeon. Tangela going to be the next target. They're getting a lot of damage. Ruby having to flash away. Here comes the flash cone from Pancake Puff. He wants to get a kill onto someone, but not able to find any more targets, just wanting to disengage a trade of one for one.
Yeah, but Haze have the inside track on the mid lane tower. They could be able to try and clear that wave, take themselves another turret for the advantage right here. And with Zanzo recalling too, they do have the numbers advantage here in the middle lane. There's a big wave in the top side too that they know Zanzo's going to have to clear away. And that might net them the Drake too.
It looks like in the bot lane, Shadow and Zod, they want to trade a tower. They have that ability with the Ziggs. It's really close. Not having the shot mana for the Satchel charge means that they're not able to just blow that up instantly. But now they're getting collapsed on by Ruby and Worku. Dodge got to be careful, taking a lot of damage from the Hammer Shock. Getting ignited. Going to be hit up by the Hammer. Ruby picking up the kill with the Cinder Hulk. Pancake Puff going to cut off Shadow. No mana for the Ziggs. He's just going to be left out to dry.
Yeah, Integrity, instead of making a coordinated play right there, you had two members running mid lane, two running bot, and of course Zanzo recalled went into the top lane, whereas Haze, they were all on the same page. Send everyone to the mid lane, go for that tower, and then turn for kills and the drink.
Well, Pancake Puff, he wants to keep going for kills because he went right onto Aeon, scaring him off, allowing his team to secure that second Ocean Drake.
Really just a zoning maneuver right there, and you gotta ask yourself if you are Zanzo. Yes, you've got a lot of minions up there in the top lane, but your team definitely did pay for it, and it's not even like you're going to be able to deny anything. Yeah, you shove in the wave all the way to the turret, but Pancake Puff has showed up, and even though he is down a level, this Akali isn't going to be slowing down on her ramp up anytime soon.
Not at all. She's sitting on 1500 gold. Has that ability to go for that Hextech Revolver right once she buys. But now I want to talk about the other parts of the field, especially talking about Ozmlex. He's the only person having a little bit hard time in this game, really getting picked off consistently. Could that be a struggle for Haze?
I don't really think so, honestly. Yes, you're going to need a big-time physical damage dealer. He's going to be effective later on. There's no doubt about that. Even right now, he is fairly strong with the finished Blade of the Ruined King, but really it's about Pancake Puff, Bubbles, and Ruby diving onto Zod and Shadow. Zod and Shadow go down, the fights are relatively easily won here for the side of Haze, and Ozmlex will be able to, at a certain point in this game, deal a lot of damage without being, you know, too cautious with himself, because if Van Cleef is using his entire burst combo onto Ozmlex, you know that that's not being used to stop the Ahri-Akali combo from diving on and killing carries.
Very true. Gotta keep your eye on, especially Pancake Puff. He's tanky, he's got damage. That's a scary Akali, if you ask me.
It definitely is right there. Finished Hextech Gunblade. Not really sure what exactly the cloth armor is going to go into. There's a lot of options here for the Akali. I think something like Azonia's Hourglass, even though you're not really worried about a lot of physical damage coming through, could be nice to try and stop the point-and-click CC of the Nautilus. maybe an Ash Arrow, anything just to reset some cooldowns within a team fight. Other than that, could go for a GA or just so many different assortments of items right now, because he's got a lot of options with the amount of CS he has. That puts him quite ahead of anyone else in this game as far as gold is concerned, I really do believe, which allows him to do a lot.
Especially compared to that of his opponent in Zenzibal, who's not going to be able to clear out the waves, not actually going to be able to tank up quite as much as Pancake Puffy is even going to be able to at this point in the game. But now, Shadow, he's getting engaged on. Here comes the Tidal Wave with that hammer, knocking him up. Zenzibal just going to try to see what he can do to delay the fight. Again, Inferno Bomb hitting onto three members. Van Cleef in the backline. Bubbles getting himself caught out, exhausted, taken really low. Asmog trying to see if he can get the damage onto Van Cleef. The whole time we saw Zod fighting against Pancake Puff on the disengage. Was Pancake Puff taken very low? Reengage coming in from Zenzibal. They locked down Ruby. He's taken very low. One more hit might get the kill. They're going to try to see if they can get the magical journey. The flash coming in. Work, you're going to be the target. He's going to be blown up, but so close to going down. Bubble connecting. That's Van Cleef picking up the kill.
Such a strange fight right there, because it was really a 4v4. Integrity botched the initial engage. The Tempered Fate canceled out the explosive cask right there from Van Cleef, and you had Zod versus Pancake Puff over in the top lane, completely astray from that fight. But it was Zod who actually came out ahead. Pancake Puff was trying to dive on towards that tier 2 turret, so the Akali was never there.
Yeah, but maybe Integrity went a little too far. Zod taking so low. They get the kill. Pancake Puff picking that one up. He got rooted down by the Cosmic Fighting, but Van Cleef gonna get shut down. The Akali picking up the kill. Zenzibal trying to see if he can return it onto Ruby. He does, but he loses his life. Pancake Puff still on the chase. He wants to get Aeon. One more hit is gonna do it, but Pancake Puff gonna be locked down. The Satchel Charge trying to get him to safety, but Red Buff slows him down too much. They get the kill for Asmolites.
Yep, started out as a one fight. Integrity got the pick onto Ruby right there, but it's the cleanup crew. This Akali, so incredibly difficult to burst down. That's why you get the early defensive items. It makes this lifesteal almost more effective because you're able to survive the burst, which allows you to have more and more time to soak up damage, be able to restore a little bit of your HP right there. And that Akali, so monstrous in that fight.
And we can even just look in this game in general how monstrous she is. Almost 2,000 gold up on Zenzibal, has the most gold in the game. The next closest person is going to be Asmolex, who has a good 700 gold less than she does.
And it's going to be a Sunfire Cape next. So this Akali, it is going to be that bruiser style you're sort of bringing up towards the early stages of this game. And that will be effective right here. We saw in the last fight more than enough damage coming out from this Akali. It's not late enough yet that you've gotten multiple completed support items from Aeon. You're not going to be able to keep your carries alive for all too long, and Pancake Puff is really going to thrive off of that fact.
Exactly. While he's not able to keep Asmolex alive, he's just like, it's okay, guys. I'll just carry instead. Don't worry, Asmolex. You just try to do your best. If you live, I guess that's great, but I'll be carrying the game.
Yeah, definitely what the idea is right here. And 30 seconds, another Drake spawning. It's an Infernal this time around. But you notice the setup going into it. Pancake Puff not grouping with the rest of the team. He knows he wins the matchup against Zanzwa. It's the difference of an entire Hextech Gunblade in gold between him and his opponent at the moment, which is pretty, pretty huge. And pulling Zanzwa up here means that he'll be able to teleport a little bit sooner.
Though Zanzwa does have the ability to cancel the teleport while Pancake Puff doesn't. So Pancake Puff has to be careful on who engages that teleport advantage first. If he's the one, could be stopped by Zenzibal, but if Zenzibal goes for it, then he's more than welcome to just join the fight.
I believe that was a blue buff stolen away by Pancake Puff right there too. So literally just taking everything here from the side of Integrity, but it's in to have control of this Drake area, and Haze are going to have to try and force around it.
Got a lot. Does see their movement. That's going to be Blast Gun. Ruby wants to lock down Zod. They're going to jump right onto the Ash, trying to see if they can get the damage. Here comes Redemption, but in the back line, we see Van Cleef on the rest of the members blocking Worku. Here comes Pancake Puff getting the damage on the Zod. They did lose Worku, but they traded two more. That's going to be 2 for 2 so far. Pancake Puff, he's a monster. He's on a rampage. He wants more. Aeon, you're not going to be able to survive. That's going to be another kill while Ruby and Asmolex are fighting Zenzibal. The Depth Charge not really going to do much as they're still on the chase. There comes the Dredge Line, trying to see if he can get himself to safety. Not going to be able to get to the Blast Gun, just knocked away by Ruby. He'll be taken down as As soon as that shield is gone, finally, Asbox getting the rampage, getting the kill.
And you just think about how these team fights are approached right here. Hayes corner Zod inside the dragon pit. Even with a flash, Zod wouldn't have been able to go over because Pancake Puff was right there. And they're looking for an inhibitor tower now at the moment, even with these low death timers.
Yeah, they just get the tower, decide to fall back, but still massive advantage for the team. 7k gold in their pockets all across the map board. You can see the items really just heavily skewing in the favor of Hayes.
Yeah, and they did secure themselves the Infernal during that fight right there. Ruby coming up clutch with a nice smite at the moment. And again, it was a very late teleport by Zanzwa as they catch Van Cleef.
Yeah, they catch Van Cleef and Zod. Zod flashing away. There comes the heal, but Pancake Puff, he's on the chase. He wants to get the kill, getting two for himself. Gonna get the lockdown onto Aeon. He's taken down. That is gonna be a kill picked up by I am Bubbles. But look at Pancake Puff, 7-0-3 on that Akali.
Oh no.
Shadow, you're not in for a good world right now. He's getting run down, killed by Worku.
Zanzwa just not even close. This could be the straw that breaks the camel's back right here, Magic. Even with just 10 seconds left on to Zod, Hayes are looking confident, are looking comfortable right here, and they want to close this out as soon as they possibly can.
But looks like they're just going to back off, maybe go for that Baron, try to end it off on a strong note, not wanting to get themselves caught out too weird in a position while they only have Shadow being dead.
Gonna go back here, at least secure vision control around the objective. Shadow still dead for 8 seconds, and they see Zod bottom lane. That means there's no team fight here for Int.
Yeah, they could use the arrow, but really not gonna do too much. Here comes Tempered Fate just to delay the Baron as long as possible. Arrow does connect on the Pancake Puff, but it's at 25%. Aeon flashing forward, Worku taking a lot of damage. Zanzibar trying to see what he can do with the Baron. Van Cleef wants to get into the pit. Worku taking very low, but not going to actually fall yet. But Explosive Gust doesn't pick up the kill. Zanzibar taking very low. They get the kill. Unstoppable for Asmux, as Zod's going to be the next target. They get the kill onto him. They get the kill onto Ruby as well. They're not going to be able to be stopped. Asbox, he wants the chase for Shadows. Shadows gotta run away, but he's not gonna make it. Ace gonna be picked up by Hayes.
Yeah, Asbox might have started off the game looking a little bit weak, but with the rest of his team doing so well, cleans up shop in that fight. You got him and Bubbles both running it down that mid lane. Gonna have the Baron to buff up those minions in just a moment, too.
Yeah, and be taken down. It's kind of hard when Pancake Puff is more of that bruiser, so not gonna get taken down quite as quickly, but still not gonna have to worry about the health. So this should be the game picked up by Hayes, so long as they continue this pressure with Asbox and Bubbles, but maybe just getting the tower then running for the hills because everyone on Integrity has spawned.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Yeah, I don't know either. Asbox got a lot of damage, but he actually might be taking out Shutdown picked up by Zod.
Yeah, it's a little bit too long right there. They thought they could end it a little bit stylish right there. Unfortunately, they could not. The game will last just a little bit longer. And Integrity, there's no thinking about that next game for them anymore. It's all about how do we win right here, because lose this and your day ends here. There's no finals for you coming on after this. This isn't game one. This is game two with your life here on the line. And they've got such a mountain that they have to climb if they do want to return.
Looking at the gold difference, 11k between the two teams separates them. That is a massive win for the side of Haze. And just looking at the board of who has all that gold, it's on the person we've been talking about all game, this Akali pickup for Pancake Puff. He has a good 5,000 gold on his opponent of Zanzibar. Just really being able to do so much work in these team fights. Well, even in the mid and bot lane, we see a 2,000 gold lead for Bubbles and a 3,000 gold lead for Asmolex.
It's the worry always. You're running a team fighting composition, but you're losing against, this more skirmish-based one. You can't win a full-on 5v5, and you don't win in the split push either. Pancake Puff can go into any lane he wants and beat anyone, any single member on the side of Integrity by himself. He could potentially 1v2. At this
and
point,
has,
with how strong he is.
And he has that Titanic Hydra as well. So he has just all this ability to help out in team fights or just split push, as we see him going to the top lane, just being like, yeah, it's fine, I don't care. I'm gonna be up here. I have teleport. I have a way to get to the team. I'm just going to get as many objectives if you guys think you're going to just go for the bot lane and try to see if you can stop all four of them.
Exactly. And right now, Integrity need to be able to force a team fight and get the TP out of Pancake.
That's what they're going to try to do. They got the Tempered Fate onto Asmolex. They're going to have the Teleport coming in. The Redemption just trying to see if it can heal up. Ruby going to be locked down for a little bit. Here comes Bubbles into the back line. There goes Pancake Puff getting the damage onto Zod. Zod going to be taken down by the spike from Ruby. They're going to be able to get Shadow as well. Going to try to see if they can get Aeon. They're able to explode everyone but Van Cleef. All the members being dead for Integrity. Haze, they look like they can end.
Yep, they're going to run it straight towards the Nexus right now. Pancake, I don't know how many turret shots you can take right there on this Akali. Van Cleef just farming up the minions, that's all you can do.
That's really all that can be said as the Nexus is gonna explode. We're gonna see the game two. We're gonna see the series taken by Haze. They're gonna make it to the grand finals.
Yeah, we'll see them face off shortly up against EVH, the team that has not been defeated ever here, at least as long as I've been casting. It's gonna be a hurdle that they have to pull themselves out of, and these are two teams that we've seen before in the finals.
Yes, this has. This is definitely something that Haze, they have a lot of, they have a huge grudge. They have to get some sort of vindiction for themselves. They have to come out here fighting. They want to take a game off of EVH. They want to take the series off of EVH, but they have to somehow be able to win in the early game, which EVH has proven time and time again that they are absolutely dominant on.
And it's so funny, too, because it's felt like Haze are just miles above their competition. You can see with the clean 2-0 victory versus Haze. But that same gap seems to be present between EVH and Haze. Not only that, but Haze are going to go in to that best of five finals. They're going to be down again. EVH, because they're the winner's bracket team, start off 1-0. They will only need two wins, whereas Haze have to figure out a way to muster three of their own, and that is definitely going to be a test for these guys. They're going to have to figure out some way during this break to be able to pull that off.
Exactly, and as we get prepare for the grand finals, we'll be throwing it over to our sponsors and throwing it over to a break, so guys, don't go anywhere. We'll be back for our grand finals here at the Go and Fun Esports Championships between EVH and between Haze.
Officers, what's going on? We're in the middle of an epic car chase. Is that why you're moving in slow motion?
Epic car chases are always done in slow motion.
That's a bit cliche. Going for a donut.
Donut.
Smart.
The moment the juice gently drips down your panty. When your taste buds meet real wholesome meat. That's when you know you're in a point of no return. You realize you're lost in the pleasures only a true meal can offer. You're lost, but you sure as hell don't want to be found. Hugo's Burger Bar. Let's burger like never before.
Life's about looking for little moments of happiness. Moments when we come out of the cold and into the welcoming warmth. Delicious leisurely mornings or long lazy afternoons where we dream sweet dreams and take the time to finally be ourselves. When you find these little moments of happiness, life becomes irresistible. A journey to be enjoyed.
and Costa is there with you, every sip of the way.